Howdy folks, welcome to episode 20. Today we're going to take our CV out on some adventures, and quickly let me show you some of the stuff I did after the last episode. So I went over to the other CV and I took off the drill turret and the harvest box, and I also made a bunch of backup parts and stuff. So this is our emergency, and for some reason this erased itself. But yeah, oh, I guess you have to turn it on. Okay, so when you turn the ship on, it does that. All right, but yeah, so this is the replacement blocks, emergency supplies, life support stuff. And this over here is, I wanted to show you guys how to do the LCDs. So you can pick a size and you can do multiple block sizes and stuff, but I'm gonna do the 0.5 by 0.5. And let's see here, there we go. And so then you select that, you do use, and then you can do, and hit that, and for some reason it just, I don't know if there's a button that I can't see over here or what, but for some reason it only updates when you click over here. But anyway, so there is our loot chest here. And let me show you here, let's do this, we'll go up in the air a bit here and auto level. All right, so we're not moving around, and I'll take the drone out. So what I did is I put doors on each of the elevators. So I've got elevator on the bottom and an elevator on the top. I put doors on each of those. And I decorated up a little bit more. And I obviously did some new textures on here. And I also figured out what I wanted to do on the front. I think this looks pretty cool. So we've got our little pinchers or whatever on the front. And the other thing I needed to do quickly before we take off is change and rotate. Now we should be able to, yeah, fix these windows, because remember, if you remember, we put on these windows backwards. And so there we go. Yep. We put on those windows on the outside, from the outside or whatever. So yeah, they're basically opaque side on the other side. So there we go. And I think that is everything. And so yeah, we have our little exit door here. And yeah, so I decided to kind of stay away from the base, which is apparently happy to see us. And well, semi-happy anyway. But yeah, I decided to stay away from the base. Too many capital vessels over there, they'll start colliding with each other and mess each other up and everything. And as you see here, I also got the ship attached so that we can bring that with us in case we need it. And so yeah, that should be everything, and I think we are ready to take off. And I probably will do something in the back. It looks like a silly face or something on the back of that, the way it is. But yeah, there's our ship, and we are loaded up with fuel and everything. Let me double check my cargo box. And yeah, okay, good. I brought a ton of fuel. That's good. All right, before we take off. So yeah, we are going to go get some Erestrum and or Zascosium. And now the other thing is, if we happen to run into a freighter, we are now in a ship that's actually capable of handling that situation, which should be pretty cool. So I'm actually kind of hoping that we'll run into one. And check out the new star map. They changed the map. That's interesting. I'm up above the planet. But yeah, they changed the map and it's still kind of new. I was going to do an actual update video on it, but I'm waiting for it to not be so weird and buggy right now as it is right now. So let's go here and let's see. Here we go. So we're going to go over to Zahines, however that's pronounced. And then from there, we will jump to the alien outpost. And there's supposed to be, let's see, there is supposed to be the, yeah, there we go. There's supposed to be the meteors that have, not meteors, but the asteroids that have the Pentaxid resource on them, which would be really cool. And we've got a freighter that has valuable goods. And so let's see what is on our map here in an outpost. And I would assume this... I like how we go to a different planet in the same star system and the sun is red now. It was green before. And yellow and white and everything. Look how the sun changes colors as you go around the same star. I'm sure they're just testing that out for future when they do have multiple star systems, but I do find that kind of funny. But anyway, let's see if we can find the Pentaxid thingy, and then I can throw that drill on the outside of this and actually get a bunch of that, because I don't want to have to worry about doing that, and I don't want to have to only, you know, restrict myself to warping here and there. And you can actually grab crystals on Oscutune. They're on the bottom of the ocean, and the thing is, they just changed it so that you can't use the drone to gather those. And so walking around at like 1.5 meters per second or whatever excruciatingly slow speed it is not something I ever want to do. So yeah, we're going to find the asteroid here. And is that it right there? It's Prometheum. Stupid Prometheum. Okay. But yeah, we're going to find, there it is. Awesome. All right. We're going to, wow, that seems really close to that thingy. Let's see if our ship will now take out this laser drone with its fancy, come on, why are my rocket turrets, there we go, okay, there we go, all right. And there's probably a couple power coils in there for us too, so let's do this. Let's see, where is he? He's right outside the door. All right, cool, perfect. So let's put on our helmet. Take your protein pills and put your helmet on. All right. And there we go. There's a couple free power coils. Awesome. Okay. So we are going to head over to the Pentaxid asteroid. And we're going to get a ton of this stuff, and hopefully I can do this. I should be able to stay out of reach of this thing, I hope. I really hope. We'll find out. That's going to be interesting if I have to go within range of this thing. The alien base is 800. Yeah, I'm not sure what its range is. So, yeah, let me back up here. And where, whoa, there he is. He's right there, come on. Thank you. All right, and there's another one somewhere up here. That's the one I think I already killed. So we'll do this. Oh, and there, yeah, okay. Yep, I guess that answers the question of whether or not I'm in range. All right, and how far is he? I don't think I will be able to loot that guy. I don't think so. Let me see. He is 94 meters away. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to reach him. All right. So I think we're going to have to take out this alien base, or maybe we'll just be able to mine some of this asteroid. So let me do this. We'll get out here, turn on our jetpack, and we'll go like this. And notice I did put a constructor in here too, and a food processor, so I can add a constructor if I need to. Where's that guy? Oh, okay, he's still far away. All right, just making sure. And we're gonna take this thing, and we're gonna put them out on the ship. So let's do this, and I can throw my loot in here too. And I thought there was another thing there. Okay. So let's do this. We'll go out here. We'll put this turret maybe on the bottom right here. I think that's a good spot for that. So we'll put the turret right here. There we go. And our harvest box, we can sit on the inside. because I don't need to. Yeah, that's fine. It's a good spot for that. All right, so at least now I'm piloting the capital ship while this is all going on. And we'll find the... Wow, warp drive took 80% damage. I need to repair that before I do anything else. Wow, I took some hits back here, didn't I? All right. Apparently, can I not hit that? There we go. Apparently, I'm going to want to put some armor on this thing if I'm going to take some hits. So, yeah, because the damage is still going through blocks and stuff like that. Okay, anyway, let's enough with the distractions, and let's find the turret. Where is it? Drill turret. Okay, cool. So here we go, and this should, yeah, this has a pretty big distance on it, so I should be able to drill my way through to some of the deposit, and I'll see if I can do that. So yeah, I will do this in a time lapse and be back in a second. And there is a... Oh, it's a freighter. Okay. Cool. All right, we can do that. We can deal with a freighter. So we found our freighter, guys. All right. I was kind of wanting to do that. So let's see here. We'll come up here. And I think it should be fairly easy to find that asteroid again since it's right by the giant space station. And yeah, you do have to watch out for those things. Let's see, what did we take? Yeah, we've got our drill turret sitting out on the front too. So this is going to be interesting. I'm going to need to see if I can... Let me see what our range is on our rocket turrets. Let's see, what does it say? Range 800 meters. Okay, so I want to see if I can get our rocket launchers into range. And the other thing you want to do on this is you want to be in front of the ship, not behind it, because then you've got the advantage of it's flying into your shots and you're flying away from its shots, so it gives you more time to dodge, and it also gives you, it gives them less time. Whoa. Wow, that is a lot of turrets. Okay. I might have to make a more heavily armed or armored. And why aren't my turrets shooting? They're supposed to have a range of 800 meters and they are not firing. Yeah, my turrets are not firing. My rocket turrets are not doing anything. I think I may need to add like some other types of turrets, maybe. Are they just not finding targets? Are they not finding targets? Yeah, I can't tell what they're doing. All right, let me check. Let me get beside this thing so it doesn't run into me again. And let me double check. So it says alien. It says turrets. So why is it not? Do I need to select other factions? Let me see. See if this thing, because we are now within range, so it should be. Yeah, they're not doing anything. Okay, something's broken with that, and I'm not going to risk this ship to get it. It's a Zascosium asteroid. Dude! Cool. Does this show... This doesn't show what's here, does it? Okay. That is really cool. Okay, we're going to get some Zascosium, too. So, yeah. That's awesome. All right, I'm going to grab some of this, and then we'll go back and get some more Pentaxid, and then we can do some warp. So I will be back in a minute. Okay, guys, I got a bunch of Zascosium. I got several hundred of it. And I'll show you that in a minute, but first I just wanted to show you this that yeah, I went out and to repair everything and yeah, this thing already took some some damage here. It basically destroyed one of these. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to also replace these windows with the armored blocks that I've got here. So I just wanted to show you that before I do it. So that's why this looks different. And so yeah, I'm going to replace that and I'll be back again. Okay, guys, we're going to approach the Pentaxid asteroid again. And I need to make sure that I'm not lining myself up with this base like that. As you can see, it wants to shoot at me at every opportunity. And so, yeah, I'm trying to make sure that I don't get lined up with it for any kill shots because it is now right within range. And let's see this thing. So I should be able to, yeah, off to my right when I'm in that. So let's try this again. We'll go into the. So here's the cargo box. Here's what we have our Zascosium. We have 540, which should be a lifetime supply for the rest of this game. And then we do need to get. I should probably grab like a couple hundred at least Pentaxid. So we're going to try to do that. All right, guys, I need to be really careful here because I think I'm going to be opening up an avenue of attack to myself if I go any farther with this. So what I'm thinking is I can probably move the ship over here and can get out. And I have a drill with me, right? Yes, I have a drill on me. And so I'm not sure if I assume this is a bug and not intended right now. But I'm gonna have fun with it anyway. I'm gonna have fun with it while I can, if I can here. But for right now, they have made it so that the drone can actually drill, and I'll show you guys here. See, the drone can actually drill now. So I'm not sure if they were intending it like that or what, but we'll see if I can get some more of this stuff. Yeah, I can get some more of it. So, yeah, I'm gonna grab some with the drone. All right, we are back, and I think we've gotten what we can easily reach. And check it out, we've got 246, so that'll do us a few trips around the solar system. Let me grab some oxygen while I'm out here. And let me see. Yeah, because I grabbed everything out of my inventory. All right, so let's take a look here real quickly. So there is another deposit right up there. Whoops. Right up there on the top, and there's another one on the front. And I bet they did that on purpose. I guess that's just mean. But yeah, that's gonna be something to do later, I think. So let's plan out where we're going here. We're gonna go to Itis quickly and grab. Let's see. We're gonna go out to Itis and we're gonna grab the. That's interesting. It makes the. It says the Masperon moon is the target. Interesting. But yeah, we're gonna go over here and let's see if we can get. Oh, okay. I need to put more in the warp engine in the tank. Okay. Let me go over here so I'm at least out of range of this thing. I am out of range, right? Yeah. Okay. All right. Let's put some stuff in the tank. Do we. Oh, you know what? I bet I'm going to have to put the constructor up in order to do this. Let's see. No, looks like, okay. All right, so we're gonna go to Masperon, and then we're going to head to Aetis. Let's go there. All right. And I do think I'm gonna have to put on the constructor in order to get back. So I think, there's a Promethium asteroid. Is that a Promethium asteroid, I assume? Let's fly by it, just so we can see. But yeah, I'm gonna have to put the constructor on this thing in order to, yeah, it's Promethium, in order to get back. But yeah, that shouldn't be a problem. I can just put a constructor on it and go. So this is Aetis. This has been updated since the last time. And we are going to go back and do some more stuff. Once we get the power coils, I'm going to upgrade this ship. I'm going to upgrade the blocks to armored, I think. All the blocks to armored. I'm going to put on more engines to make it faster. And I'm going to use the power coils to put on fixed weapons, because I think fixed weapons are really the key to taking out the ships, the freighters and stuff like that. It's just I haven't been able to do that because of the lack of power coils, which we're about to solve. So yeah, I'm going to land over here or fly around over here, and I will let you guys know when I find an Erestrum deposit. That looks like the abandoned mine. Yes, it is. And there we go. There is an Erestrum deposit. Let's see where it is over here. All right, 6,800. That is plenty. And there are no POIs to get in our way. So we should be good. I love that you can't shoot this weapon on a planet because the AI is trying to shoot the the thing. Because yeah, some of the aliens on this, or some of the wildlife on this, are considered aliens by the game. And so yeah, like these guys here. And yeah, there's apparently lots of baddies over here. So I will be able to get out the top of the ship. And let's see, let's just do this. Just leave it leveled. Leave it leveled. And so what we can do is, since they've got this thing set up this way, we don't even need to go out there to mine the Erestrum. We can just take our drone out there. And what is this guy? Oh, is that one of those? That's one of the new guys. Cool, these guys are new with the update. The red thingies. The red, I forget what they're called now. Alien assassins. And then we've got alien bugs here. And let's see, where's the deposit? So it's right here on the surface. Cool. And we are on resource mining, right? Yep. All right, so I'm going to grab a bunch of this and I will be back in a minute. All right, guys, we have 320 ore, and yeah, dug out a little hole there. So yeah, this is just one way to do it. There are other ways to do this same thing without having to deal with the wildlife. Obviously, you could bring a hovercraft and you could use the hovercraft to drill. The wildlife don't attack you in the hovercraft. What you can also do is you can put sentry guns turrets on the bottom of your ship or the sides or whatever, and that will take care of any wildlife before you even get out of your ship. Let me do this while I am talking. And another thing you can do is you can build a CV with a skirt around the bottom. You just make a skirt out of blocks and leave a hollow, you know, spot underneath the bottom, and you just get out and start digging, and nothing can get through your skirt to you know, to attack you that way. So I mean, there are a ton of ways to deal with wildlife. The other thing you can do is you can just park your ship, and you know, you can here you can park your ship and you can stand on top of it and shoot stuff. Really? This thing isn't very epic today, huh? Or that thing has a ton of hit points. There we go. Okay, but yeah, I mean, you know, there's a million ways to do this. To once you go mining for these ores on another planet, there's a million ways to do it in which you don't really have to deal with all of the wildlife. And so let me get this thing out of here too. And I'm going to put down the constructor because I'm going to need that to refine some of this and get home. So let me do that, and I will meet you guys in just a minute. Okay, guys, we are up in space, and I've got enough of these manufactured that I think we can get home. And so I'm just going to throw these in the warp drive tank and head home. So we will go to Maspron first. And the alien outpost. And Zehines. And home to Oskatoon. All right, so that is the entire trip, and we've got, yeah, I picked up a couple of alien parts, but yeah, we've got the stuff we need to make a bunch of power coils, and so I'm going to craft those offline, and, or actually, let me see, yeah, I'll craft those offline, because I think you guys know how to make power coils, and yeah, I will get those crafting, and we will build some cool stuff. The next time we go out adventuring, we will have some better armor, and we will have mounted weapons and stuff like that, and so this thing is going to kick some alien butt, I think. But next episode, I think we're going to try to get a little more building done on the big tree. So join me in episode 21 for some cool building, and we will see you then. Later!